You guys are also going to find out why this video is late, as well as the Big Test April with Me video. Let me just apologize for that intolerable behavior. Hello everybody, welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Mahlodi Panda and this is where we talk about streetwear, lifestyle and forex trading. March was a very eventful month. Like, I can't even fake happiness anymore. March started bad, it became really, really good, and then it ended really, really bad. You guys are also going to find out why this video is late, as well as the Big Test April with Me video. Let me just apologize for that intolerable behavior. When March started, I had so much schoolwork to do because school had just started, and then I had to like really catch up with school and just go with the program or get with the program. So that's something that I was really fighting to do this month. And I had this one assignment, guys, that I fought so hard to finish and submit on time. But hello guys, so I am finally done with my assignment. It's actually 11 p.m. right now and I'm done with my assignment. I'm just trying to check for plagiarism before I actually submit the stuff. So I have been looking for like only registered and verified users can. Guys, gantu yetsalang. Maybe let me show you guys what I'm doing. So I am done with my assignment, but what I need to do right now is that I just want to check for any plagiarism, you know, because I'm not trying to like have stuff like, you know. Okay, great, finally. So I'm just checking for any plagiarism right now. I don't want to submit it without checking any plagiarism, right? So I've just submitted it onto this free website. It's called Playgram. And I want to check for like plagiarism, AI content check, you know, and that sort of thing. And it's taking so long, guys. It is taking so long. Like, I don't know what's happening, but it's taking so long. Or do I have to pay? Guys, I want those free websites. I'm not gonna pay for something that I don't know, that I've never used. There's another one called Qtix. Hey, and Tor. I don't even have references. I'm gonna have to put them in alphabetical order. And then, guys, I'm done with my assignment. I'm gonna show you guys in a little bit. Oh, let me see how it looks. Let me show you guys. So, this is the assignment. Maybe let me... Oh, guys, that's me. And then... This is supposed to be in the middle. I'm gonna fix that.
And I had a little challenge where I couldn't find a free platform that I can use, or an affordable platform that I can use to check for plagiarism. And one thing about me, guys, is that I'm not gonna spend like a lot of money to do something that, you know, I can do myself, even if it's gonna take me like a very, very long time doing it myself. But like, if you are a machine and you can do something very, very fast, then can it please be like very affordable, you know? Because at the end of the day, like, let's even forget me being a forex trader, because although I'm consistently profitable, I don't rely on my forex profits for money. But I have a 9-to-5, and this 9-to-5, I help support my family with my salary from the 9-to-5. That's the money that I rely on. Fun fact, my phone, this phone is the first thing that I ever got on contract. Just keep that in mind, okay? So and then the next thing that happened was that I wasn't paying attention that much on my trading this past month, because I had so much schoolwork to do. But I had this one trade that I was really following, and this one position that I really would have loved it to play out. So this position I actually traded before I traded NFP and CPI. So immediately after this next footage that you guys are going to see, that's when I traded my NFP and CPI.
It's the dollar index. Yo, currently what's one at me? Let's see if the market will respect this channel the way that it respected this one, the way that it respected this one. Now I want to see if it will respect this one. So basically, this is how I trade, guys. I allow the market to reveal itself. I don't, like, I allow the market to reveal itself, unless if I'm seeing what is happening, you know? And then let me just put this here. You see this pattern that I've drawn? Let me remove these. This is not real. All of the things that I've removed are not relevant anymore. So this pattern, guys, it's a bullish pattern, okay? Now, I want the market to come here, and then it will come down from there. This is one thing that could happen. I'm just gonna take a screenshot. This is one thing that may happen, guys. And also, this is on the daily. Remember that, okay? This is on the daily. So, one. Let's see on the 1 hour. Let's see the patterns that I created on the 1 hour, and then we can determine if the market is going to respect or not. Okay, with this candlestick, it looks like the market is going to respect it, but I think it will reveal itself more during the US session. Right now, it's still early, guys. It's still early. Right now, it is London session, so I want to see if the market will buy to like this area. Let me be modest, hey? It's getting a little bit excited, you know? So if the market is really going to buy from here, it should create this piece of price action here. Do you guys see it? Do you guys see it? Do you not see it? Do you guys see it? Do you not see it? Okay, I don't know if you guys see it, but I can see it, you know? This right here. Okay, let me just move this aside. That is the same as this. The only difference is that there was a fair value gap here, and here there isn't a gap. But you can see, let me just see something. Okay, now, you know, this here is the same as this here. What is being created right now is this. Do you see it? Okay, I can see it. Another thing, guys, is like, the more you trade, the more in-market experience you have, the more you can decode what is happening in the market. And then your intuition also gets stronger. And then, yeah. So here, right? Let me... But then here, guys, let me show you guys something. Here,
But yeah, guys, the market created this whole thing where it broke and retested and then it went up. But the time when it broke and retested, it was like 9 p.m. ish. You know, it was like 9 p.m. ish South African time. But on the other side, I think it will create this piece of price action. This piece of price action at about like New York session South African time. So I'm just waiting to see. Okay, I'm just waiting to see. Let's see. So let's count the confluences, okay? Okay, now the chart is missing. So yeah, maybe let's just leave it at that and then we will come back to it later.
The dollar index is still correcting. So I haven't entered any trades, right? But I'm just waiting to see if market will break this area. If it will break the gray area and go into the yellow area, come back, bounce on, and then I will take the trade as it's retracing. If it doesn't retrace onto this area, it will retrace onto that area. Market has moved, you know, but I'm not gonna take it yet. I'm waiting for this move now. This part of the move, number three, you know, the retest. Once it creates the retest, then I'll take it. But for now, it ain't what I needed to be.
So, looking at the dollar index, this is the analysis from yesterday, right? As you guys can see, yesterday the market did not move in our favor, you know. But it does not mean that the bias is wrong. It just means that we have to wait a little bit longer. And another thing that you need to remember, guys, do not marry a position. If you can see that 2 days goes by, guys, and you can see that there's no way the market is going to respect the market conditions that you had expected the market to respect. If it doesn't do that, then it's fine for you to change your bias. So yeah, this is what I meant by you need to allow the market to reveal itself, guys. So
we got taken out by this engulfing, which a signal to us that we definitely are going down.
So that position, guys, I would have loved for it to play out the way I had intended it to play out, but that was just a lesson that showed me that, you know what, like in Forex, you can never win each and every trade. And it reminded me that you can do everything right with your trading approach or trading strategy and you can still lose the trade. But I am very proud of myself for sticking to my plan, number one, and number two, just being patient and allowing the market to reveal itself. But I must say that I was very, very disappointed with XM, because that's a trading platform that I use. So on XM, I trade the XM standard account with low spread. I was in profit, but I wasn't in the kind of profits that I'm used to seeing or getting, and that frustrated me so much. But it is what it is. It just means that I need to find a broker that will enable me to trade the dollar index and get the amount of profit that I expect to get, or I had intended or expected to get. So that's that on the trading this past month. After that, I bought new YouTube equipment. So when I say YouTube equipment, I just mean my ring light. I bought a brand new ring light because my old ring light, I don't know if you guys watched my trade, like biggest trades, my biggest trades of my life video. In that video, there's like a ring light stand or a camera stand on the background without the ring light. So the ring light broke. Unfortunately, I don't have pictures to show you guys, but the ring light broke and I couldn't attach my phone onto the ring light anymore. It was falling over. It was just giving me problems. So I had to buy a brand new ring light. And then I bought better. Thank you.
brand new ring light. I really, really like this ring light.
And that is Easy Equities. So this past month, I was hanging out with my cousin and I don't know how, but we started talking about Easy Equities. And then he was like, do you know Easy Properties? I'm like, yeah, I saw it on the platform back then when I was trading Easy Equities, but I never really gave it like my energy because Easy Equities was just so slow. I have bought stocks on Easy Equities, and like, guys, people who were in my life during that time and listened to me at that time made a lot of money, because, and I know this because I also made a lot of money during that time. This was back in 2019, or was in 2020, just after COVID. I was like, guys, buy ARM. If you don't know what ARM is, ARM is a group where inside of ARM, it's Time Bank, it is Rain Mobile. Let me just be sure, but I know that it is, guys, I just forgot what it's called. ARC, sorry guys, not ARM, it was ARC. So I told a bunch of my friends and I was like, guys, buy ARC. I remember having invested about 300 rand in there, and my returns were like 700 and something rand. And you know, I think I bought it at the most perfect time because it was like five rand or like 4 rand 50 at that time for a share, and I just had a whole 300 rand in there, guys. And then I just forgot about it, and then how one day I go in there, I'm like, what, I made like 700 and something rand from that. But I never really like pursued the Easy Equities because I, like, it was too slow for me. You know, when you're used to like very fast things like Forex. Forex is very volatile. I can make 700 rand in a minute, in a second. I can lose it in a second, you know? So I think me being used to that, or my mindset being used to that, I was just like, ah, man, you know? It's not my thing, you know? But my cousin's like, hey, bruh, Easy Properties, it's where it's at, you know? So I'm gonna be looking into Easy Properties, and I will be talking about that. Maybe I'll make a separate video for that on my YouTube channel, but I still have to like educate myself on Easy Properties as well as Easy Equities. But Easy Equities, it's quite easy for me. It was easy for me to catch on because I didn't even read the fundamentals or whatever. I just read the chart and I predicted what could happen based on how I predict my Forex charts. I used the same knowledge to predict whatever's happening, what might happen on that chart. And, you know, things went good for me. And then I broke my money box for that, guys, because the plan was for me to take that money, because instead of saving into like a savings account or saving in a money box, my cousin was like, dude, just save that money inside Easy Equities, and since you already understand the shandies, it can be easy for you. So that was the plan, guys.
Like, a couple of days ago I was with my cousin, and you know, we spoke about Easy Equities, and we spoke about, like, he showed me the property side of Easy Equities. So it's Easy Properties. And guys, I was on Easy Equities for a while. I did make like a lot of bank trading ARM. After investing into ARM. But what I didn't like about Easy Equities is the fact that I had to wait for so long to start making like money from my investment. But like, I made like a really good amount of money. I literally made like I think I made like 70% or 75% of my capital. So, and like, when we were just talking, you know, I had an idea. I'm like, bruh, I have so much money in my money box.
and the money is just sitting there. I could just invest it into Easy Equities and then, like, you know, because there is money that I save, right, on the, like, in my Scotto Foto. And in here, guys, it's like extra money. And if I'm not mistaken, I have over 1,000 rand in here. So I want to break this. Also, I've got money, like, in my drawer. I've got like 250 rand. I had 400 rand, but I used the other 200 rand to buy like Chinese. I really wanted Chinese today, as I ate Chinese. So, but I really just wanna like do this, guys. I wanna do this because I thought to myself, like, if this money is just sitting, you know, how much bag could I be making if I had the money in Easy Properties? The thing about Easy Properties is that it's a little bit more expensive than Easy Equities. But you know what? Property never depreciates in value unless if it's not being maintained. It always appreciates in value. So somewhere in this vlog, you guys will see me actually do... like Easy Equities work, you know? Yeah. Easy Equities, please sponsor me. I will show you guys how I use my technical analysis techniques that I use in Forex when I'm using technical analysis, how I use that or translate that into Easy Equities and now Easy Properties. So yeah, guys, that's something that I really, really want to jump on to. Right now, I'm gonna like break this. I need to flip and break this open because I need to take the money that's in here and do something special with it. Can you guys hear that? You guys think that it's cents in here. I know you guys think it's just cents, it's coins. You know what? Let me surprise you. Let me shock you. Let's count this money together, okay? So this is the 250 that has always been there. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800 850 870 880 890.
And then I broke my money box for nothing because I just ended up spending that money the way I didn't want to spend it. But you know what, it is what it is, you know. I will do better as time goes. I will have better days. I had the biggest trades of my entire life. You know, it's very unfortunate that all of the best parts when it comes to trading, like, I don't record them. Like, I literally don't record them. They just happen when I am not even paying attention, when I'm not even recording. But that's why I decided to invest in a vlogging camera. Hello. because this YouTube channel is me documenting my entire life, not only my forex trading journey, but me growing into the person that I want to become, or the best version of myself, as well as you guys coming along on that journey with me and you guys witnessing me, like, my life changing or my life improving through forex, whether it being forex or me having a 9-to-5, you know. But the ultimate plan is for my life to change because of my Forex profits, which is one of the niches of this YouTube channel. But I don't want to make this channel all about money, because there are so many other YouTube channels that make this Forex thing more about like money and stuff like that. And that's another reason why, like, I don't want to show you guys my numbers. And part of the reason why I don't want to show you guys my numbers is because, like, I don't want to feel that amount of pressure to keep up or keep doing better, you know. But you guys will see that I am doing better with my quality of life, or my standard of life, you know, just me improving within my lifestyle, whether being me buying myself brand new YouTube equipment, me redoing my bedroom, or me renovating my parents' house, or you seeing parts of the house that don't look the same no more, you know. So yeah, guys, so I had the biggest trades of my life. And when I say the biggest trades of my life, I don't mean like the position or whatever, but I mean like the amount of profits that I made from those positions or those trades. So the way that I trade, or the way I structure my trading accounts, is that I have one main account. So this one main account, that's the account where I risk like 1%, 2%. And then I have another main account, which I'm sorry guys if you're watching, but this is like maybe to my friends or my other trading partners or my trading people, where I'm like, I take screenshots and then I share those results with them. And that's the account that, you know, sometimes I feel like, you know what, I'm going all in. You know, when you see me talking about 500 rand in my account or 700 rand in my account, that's the account that's like, it's for the public. Or, but when I say public, I mean like my friends and that sort of thing. And I have other accounts that I fund. So this is the new thing that I've really adopted, where I've got other accounts that I fund for specific news events, and then I trade those. So those are accounts where I call those like grow or blow accounts. So on my main account, like my secret account, like I hit it big, you know, I really, really hit it big. And like, I'm just so, I don't know if I should say like thankful, but like, like, I don't, like, guys, I don't even know how to explain it, because I've also never touched that kind of money at like all at once, you know, all at once. Like, I've touched like 20,000 rand cash, I've touched like 30,000 rand cash, but I've never touched like 100 grand or more than 100 grand cash, you know. But that's something that happened in like this past month. And like, although I didn't have the money cash I had in my bank account, guys, I don't even want to talk about the numbers. I don't know, I think I'm gonna like edit this part out. But I had like this amount of money that, like, I've dealt with the emotions of making that amount of money. And like, I've decided to also take a trading break due to that, because I was like, you know what, like, I need to reset my mindset, because now I'm not trading a 100 grand account, but I'm starting from scratch, because I've used that money, or I've invested that money into things that I have always wanted to do, but I was never, or never had the capacity to do before in my life. So you guys will see a few changes, you know, in my life here and there. Just know that, you know what, like, I'm in this bitch. So I hit it big. One of the things that I really wanted to do, and I spoke about this in my previous video when I did mention that I want to buy a vlogging camera, and I want...
Hi guys, so today is the 20 something, okay, of March. And guys, I'm so excited. We got a package today from Takealot. We got a couple other packages too, okay? But We've got a couple other packages too. But this one in particular, I wanted to unbox it with you guys because I spoke about this in my February vlog, my February recap vlog. So I'm really, really excited for this, guys. It took hard work, blood, sweat, tears to get what is in here. Let's unbox and then we'll talk some more. Like, yeah. Guys, I don't know if you see which model is this.
Huh?
It's the latest one. It's my Canon GX7 Mark III. It's the power shot. Guys, I'm so excited. Let me open it. I don't know if maybe I should have done this for TikTok. But you know what? TikTok is not my thing. But you know what? YouTube, you guys are my people. Let's see what's inside. It's just these product papers. You know, we don't read these things, but I think this might come in handy. Because I'm gonna have to download the app so that whenever I wanna get like the pictures and stuff, I can just get them through Bluetooth, or is it the Wi-Fi thing? I'm not quite sure. And there's this little book that we don't read. And then it's the battery. I ordered two more batteries like this. I don't know when will they be arriving. And then what's this? Oh, this is that thing. Guys, I did mention that there's construction happening in the house, so bear with me. I'm also gonna be talking to you guys about what's happened, okay, or what's happening. I don't know. So no, I do know. And then there's this cord. I think this is the charging cord. Also, maybe let me just tell you guys that I'm responsible for the construction, okay? Leave a comment in the description box and then maybe just guess what I mean. Yeah. And then this is the cord, the charging cord that goes inside of this. Like that. It's the Canon thing. It has like the whole Canon battery charger. Woo! Masadi! That's all. And then guys, I can't believe this. I literally spoke about this in my last vlog and right now I have it. And I don't know if you remember. Okay, let me unbox. Let me stop talking because I hate it when other creators do that. Guys, this is the back, this is the front. And the camera screen flips up. Guys! Let me put in the battery. It opens like this. And then it should go in like that. Oh, my God. And then the on and off button is right there at the top. I don't know if you see, it says on and off, and then yeah. Guys, it's on. Okay, what's the date today, buddy? What's the date today? March 27th, month 3. What's the time? 7:40. That is not the right time. Oh. 17:34. 17:34. I'm gonna say 35. Oh, I don't know if you guys saw what I was doing. I'm just gonna see. London? No, not London. Cairo. We are +2. Yes, Cairo. What's this? Daylight saving time. I like it. Daylight saving. Apply effects. Press the creative assistant button. Or hide next time. Okay. No card in the camera. What? Okay, that is so disappointing. Hopefully, by the time, so disappointing. Okay, let me.
And I wanted to, I didn't want to rely on my Forex profits for that, but I wanted to, I was saving up for a vlogging camera. You know, guys, like when that money came in, I gave it like 2 days to think about what I wanted, but the main thing that was always on my mind was brand new YouTube equipment, brand new YouTube equipment, and a very comfortable chair, because I do a lot of sitting down at this desk, and like I do a lot of working in my bedroom, because if you guys don't know, I'm a full-time student. I have a 9-to-5, I do YouTube, and I do Forex. So all four of those things just require me, like require attention or energy, or mental energy, where like I'm sitting down and I'm working. Like I spend so much time in my bedroom. Like people who know me personally know that I spend like, sometimes I could be in my bedroom like the entire day. I'll just leave my bedroom to brush my teeth, to eat, to bath, and then come back straight into my bedroom. If I'm not sitting on the bed, you know, I'm sitting on my chair. And you know, I'm so thankful for this chair, because my previous chair was so uncomfortable that it caused me to sometimes like sit in my bed the whole day and work on my bed. And you know, that's why I have that little like working table, working desk where I can work on my bed. And that's the reason why I just needed a flat surface that I can work on while I'm chilling in bed. I mean, that desk will still come in very, very handy, because I do have very early mornings where I'm like up at like 3 a.m. or like 4 a.m. You know, those are mornings where I just run out of sleep. And then I decide, you know what, let me just work on something, you know. Because also those four things are not only the only thing that I'm working on. I do have other hobbies on the side. But yeah. So I bought brand new YouTube equipment. My mother recommended somebody who can do home renovations for us. Guys, everything was going well. Okay, it was going well until plumbing was involved. You know, usually, you know, let me give you guys a tip, okay? Never believe somebody who says, I can do everything.
Okay.
You know what? They can't do everything. You know, there's a reason why people go to trade school. They go and educate themselves on a certain trade so that they can master that one trade. And usually people who master plumbing don't do electricity. If you do tiles, you don't do electricity, you don't do plumbing, you know? Or like tiles is just that one thing that, okay, you know what, it's whatever. I don't work in construction anymore, so I can't speak on that. The plumbing in the house, like the guy, you know, for lack of a better word, he fucked up everything, guys. He fucked it up. He ruined everything. You know, there are certain things where, like, you know, they're just obvious that, you know what, you don't know what you were doing. First of all, we were buying material on top of material on top of material. And, you know, the project was just supposed to be for a week, okay? And it went on to the next week. And keep in mind, guys, that I was on leave when I decided, you know what, let's do this project because I'm going to be at home. I will be there to oversee everything. Guys, first week, how am I? They're working, cool. Second week, like, okay, on Monday, we'll be done. Guys, Wednesday hits. Guys, I felt myself getting depressed day by day, losing morale, losing the... not being as zealous as I was when everything started. And my camera is a little skew now, guys. Please forgive me. But, like, this guy, it literally did not end well, guys. It did not end well. So basically, his greed led me to spend all of the money, the budget that I had for the home renovations and over. Because there was another project that I wanted to do, or now that I'm doing on the side, but now my salary has to fund that, whereas that was never the plan. And yo, guys, I was so depressed. And now it's that type of thing where it's like, Mahlodi, you decided to take on this project by yourself, and like nobody in the house was doing it because nobody in the house could afford to. So now are you expecting us to now chip in our money? You know, like sensible people could chip in their money. Like normal people would just do that. But because I am also not one to be like, hey, you know, look at what I'm doing and now I need help. Like I'm not a person who's like that. Like I've always had the kind of, I've always been so stubborn in terms of like me being able to do things on my own, or me wanting to do things on my own and not expecting help from other people. That comes from a certain trauma that I experienced when I was a child. And you know, that's something that I'm working on. But you know, it's really great for me to know that, you know what, I can do things on my own. Like I've always been that person. So now I have to find somebody who will not only fix that guy's mistake, but now I need to spend more money that in reality I don't have. And another thing that I don't want to do is like blow through my savings, because my savings are like, I need my savings. Like a person just needs to have that money on the side that nobody knows about. But I'm just trying to keep a positive mindset. And you know, I can feel myself getting deeper and deeper into a hole. And you know, I don't want to go back into that hole because I took myself out of that hole and I don't want to go back. But so I'm going to be doing things that will help me stay out of that hole. And you guys will see me, like I will talk about those things as time goes. Cool. Now, another thing that I did, now I'm done with all of the bad news. Okay, let's talk about the good news. Now, with the good news is that I decided, you know what, I want to treat myself. You know, I've worked so hard. I want to treat myself. I want to buy myself things that, you know I can maintain on my salary, but I can't buy on my salary. And so I decided to buy myself entry-level luxury goods. I've always known that I'm a girly girl at heart, okay? But I don't think I was confident enough to put that out on my sleeve and be like, yeah, I'm a girly girl, you know? I've always been the type of person who has the mentality where I'm like, I'm gonna start embracing my girly girl side once I have a car. Because, guys, let's be honest, okay? If you are a beautiful girl in South Africa, you're not safe. I'm not saying anything bad about, like, you know, other people, but if you are beautiful and you are sexy and you are proud and you use public transport, and when I say public transport, I'm including Uber, guys, like, you're not safe. You are not safe. I mean, so therefore I've always had it in at the back of my mind that, like, the moment I have my own car or I have, like, my own things that will make me feel safe in my space, I'm gonna start embracing that part of me. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be a tomboy. And now you guys know why I'm a tomboy or why I'm not a girly girl like that. It's because I just don't feel safe. I don't feel safe. These are things that I'll talk about on my YouTube channel. Like, the more the more I work on myself and, you know, my childhood traumas, the more I'm able to unpack certain things, beliefs about myself, and now I understand why I do the things that I do or why I think the way that I think. And those are things that I will talk about more, you know, as we go into the year. Also because literally trading Forex has helped me a lot when it comes to overcoming these childhood traumas. And we'll talk about why, all right, and how. So another thing that I bought was a purse. Another thing that I bought was a wallet. So the idea with this wallet is that, like, when I'm going to things like festivals, when I'm going to parties, you know, when I don't want to carry a very big bag, I can just have that and then just whip it out and then, you know. So I'm literally staying on the same level or the same standard in different settings. Yeah, so another thing that I bought for myself is a handbag. Guys, I have these really, really, really beautiful boots that I've never worn because I have an idea of an outfit in my head that I'm not gonna wear that outfit while I'm using public transport. I'm sorry, I'm not gonna do that. But I was like, you know what? Because I can see things are coming together, you know, let me just. And I really, really loved that bag because it's literally my style. You know, everything that I buy that is like girly, girly or like tomboy, it's literally my style. So yeah, guys, I decided to just treat myself on that. By the way, the bag is from Aldo. It's not Guess, it's from Aldo. So I bought them from Bash, my very trusted retail group. So yeah, guys, like, I've always been a Bash girl. Like, you guys are only jumping on it now, you know, but I've always been a Foschini girl. I've always been a Aldo girl. Okay, let me not lie, not so much Aldo, but Foschini. I've always been a Foschini girl. So and Total Sports. So yeah, guys, and then I bought myself a vlogging camera and then home renovations. And then yeah, guys, so those are the things that happened in this past month that I just really want to go into this next month with a grateful heart of having received, and just remembering that, you know what, in the midst of everything bad that happens, there is good that will come out of it. So right now, it's just a matter of me just pushing as much as I can, just carrying on, gunning for my dreams, because now I'm in a position where, like, I've established myself in such a way where it will be easier for me to achieve my goals and live my dreams. So yeah, guys, literally that's been me for this past March. Currently I am on a trading break, so that's why you guys see me like really slowing down also on like content and everything. And like, I just told myself that I want to go on a trading break, but this trading break will end in the end of April. It should end, because I miss the adrenaline, you know. I really really miss the adrenaline. But because I really just want to reset my mind, I've decided to take time off the actual trading and, you know, reread trading books that have shaped me into becoming the trader that I am today, you know, just for me to remember why I started, and why I should not stop. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for your continuous support. I really really appreciate it. It means a lot to me. And if you like this kind of content, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, leave a comment in the description box and tell me what would you have done if you had like the biggest trades of your life and you had the money to do it. What would you have done, you know? And as well as share my videos, because a lot more is coming. We've got better quality now, we've got everything now, and you know, greater things are coming.